Hasten to help me, O Lord, of my salvation.
O God, my God, at dawn I rise
promised you, my soul has thirsted for you, and know how my flesh has hungered for you. Like the desolate and trackless land that has no water, should it, I come before you in your holy place to see the power and the glory that are yours. And your love is better than life itself, my lips shall declare your praise. They shall I bless you as long as I live, and lift my hands and call upon your name. My soul shall be filled with joy, despair, and beautiful lips will praise your name. As I lay on my couch, I remember you, I meditated on you throughout the early watches, that you became for me the help of wind and shelter, your wings I will find delight. My soul clings to you, and your right hand holds me up. Better to those who sought my life in vain than they seek into the depths of the earth, and be given over to the sword of prey of jackals they shall be. The king shall rejoice in God, and all the square by him shall flourish, for the mouth of the Lord is stopped. I meditate on you throughout the early watches, that you became for me the help of wind and shelter, and your wings I will find delight. My soul clings to you, and your right hand holds me up. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen.
O Lord God, my salvation, day and night I cry out before you. At my prayer, reach up, you lend your ear to my appeal, O Lord. For my soul is still in trouble, and my life being close to Hades, I was reckoned with those who go down in the pit. I was like a man of the young, held up for dead. Like the slain left the eye in the grave, those who remember no more, they are cut away from your hand. You have cast me down from the deepest abyss into darkness and the shadow of death. Your anger was a burden upon me, you put your bellows over. You took my friends away from me, you made me notice to them. I was closed and you could not escape, my eyes from him in distress. I cried out to you, O Lord, all day I stretched out my hands to you. For you work wonders for the dead, and physicians and graves, and love to see you praise. Is anyone seeing your love in the grave, or your truthfulness in the midst of perdition? Are your marvels ever known, your darkness, or your justice in the land of oblivion? And yet, O Lord, I cried out to you, do you my prayer shall rise upon? Why, O Lord, do you reject my prayer? Why do you hide your face away from me? I am wretched and troubled since my youth, I was raised high and humbled in distress. Your plagues have swept over me, your cares have left me shaken. They surround me like waters all the day, they move in upon me from all sides. You have distant me from my friend and neighbor and my acquaintance, so wretched am I. O Lord God, my salvation, yea, and that I cried out before you. Let my prayer reach up to you, and you hear to my plea, O Lord.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, may all that is in me bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all the gifts from him, who pardons all your sins and heals all your infirmities, who ransoms your life from corruption and crowns you with his love and mercy, who fills your longing with what is good in your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord performs deeds of kindness and vindication for all the oppressed. He has made known his ways to Moses and his will to Israel's children. The Lord is the land of compassion and mercy, long-suffering and manifold love, his contention is not forever, nor will his own anger always last. He has not dealt with us our sins to man, nor does he repay our evil deeds. For his high to heaven stand over the earth, so far as the Lord extended his love for those who feared him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed our sins from us. As kind a father is to his children, so is the Lord to those who fear him. For he himself and his well are we reformed. Remembers we are only made of dust. He may in his days resemble grass as the flower of the fields, so shall he bloom. But let a breeze pass over him, and he is gone, never shall he know his place again. The love of the Lord is from all eternity to all eternity for those who fear him, and his justice is upon the children of those who keep his covenant and remembrance his laws to obey him. The Lord has established his throne in heaven and for all things his kinship is supreme. Blessed the Lord, O you, his angels, you strong and mighty ones who obey his word on hearing the sun. Blessed the Lord, O you, his parents, his attendants who obey his will. Blessed the Lord, O you, his works in every place of his dominion. Blessed the Lord, O my soul. Blessed the Lord, O my soul, in every place of his dominion.
O Lord, hear my prayer and goodness, give heed to my feet and my dispensation. And enter not into judgment in your service, as all living God says to your sight. The enemies having died, has touched my life in the ground. His fortune is in the darkness, I feel as long dead, my spirit facing the feet, with me, my heart is in despair. I recall the days of old, and make me all your feet, but upon the roots of your hand. I stretched out my hand to you, and the heart stand, my soul thirst for you. Make haste to answer me, O Lord, my spirit is dead, and turn not your face away from me, lest I be like those who live. Grant that I may hear steadfast on the dawn, for I place my hope in you. O Lord, teach me the way I should go, for I look on my soul. O Lord, deliver me from my enemies, it is you that I have that teach me to do your work, for you are my God. May your good spirit be my shaped path, for the sake of your name, O Lord, you keep me alive. In your righteousness you will deliver me from affliction, and in your loving kindness you will destroy my enemies, and bring to naught all those who oppress me, for I am your servant. O Lord, hear my prayer, and your truthfulness give heed to my plea, and your righteousness answer me. May your good spirit be our shaped path. Walks up out of the day, okay, you open them up, you can eat, get any case, still on the home. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God.
Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God.
Alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia, glory to you, O God.
churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. Spirit. Lord, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Thank you.
sting of death for Christ, you beat Adam from the curse of the lover of humanity. Therefore, we all cry out to you to save us, O Lord.
Save us, O Lord.
The women heard the angel's words and put off the linen, becoming joyful. Trembling, they looked upon the resurrection, and behold, Christ came to them, saying, Rejoice, take courage. I have overcome the world and have freed the prisoners. Go teach the disciples, inform them that I go before you to preach in the city of Galilee. Therefore, we all cry out to you, save us, O Lord.
Save us, O Lord. On July 8, we commemorate the holy, great martyr Procopius. St. Theodosia, the mother of St. Procopius, died by the sword. The 12 women of the senatorial rank died by the sword. The holy martyrs Antiochus, Nicostratus, Abdas, and Sabas died by the sword. The devout Theophilus, who lived in asceticism on the holy mountain of Athos, reposed in peace. The holy new hired martyr Anastasius, who was from Ios Vlastios Egumenitsa, witnessed in Constantinople and died by the sword in the year 1743. May the holy intercession devote a mercy on us, O men.
My mouth shall I open wide and thus speak spirit of you. A word shall then pour out into the mother queen. I will joyously of the celebration and sing to her merry.
To the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things, and behold, I set the promise of my Father upon you. But stay in the city until you are clothed with power from on high. Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. As he blessed them, he parted from them and was carried up into heaven, and they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and were continually in the temple, praising and blessing God.
For you are our God. Apart from you, we know no other. We call upon your name. Come, all the faithful, let us venerate the holy resurrection of Christ. For behold, through the cross, joy has come to the whole world. Ever blessing the Lord, let us praise his resurrection. For having endured the cross for us, he destroyed death by death. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your very morning, to the abundance of your compassion, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my lawlessness and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my lawlessness and my sin is always before me. Against you only have I sinned any evil in your sight, that you may be justified in your words and overcome when you are judged. For behold, was conceived in transgressions and in sins my mother bore me. Behold, you love truth, you show me the unknown and secret things of your wisdom. You shall sprinkle me with hyssop, and I will be cleansed. You shall wash me, and I will be made whiter than snow. You shall make me your joy and gladness, the bones of poor my womb shall greatly rejoice. Turn your face from my sins and blot out all my transgressions. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence. Do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation and uphold me with your guiding spirit. I will teach transgressors your ways, and the ungodly shall turn back to you. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall greatly rejoice in your righteousness. For O shall open my lips, and my mouth will declare praise. For if you desire sacrifice, I will give it to you, and I'll be pleased with all burnt offering. The sacrifice of blood is a broken spirit, a broken and humble heart, God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in your good pleasure, design let the walls of Jerusalem be built. Then you will be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with offerings, all burnt offerings. Then shall they offer young bulls on your altar, and have mercy on me, O God.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. At intercession of the apostles, O Lord of mercy, blot out my many offenses, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. At the intercession of the apostles, O Lord of mercy, blot out my many offenses. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy, and according to the abundance of your compassion. Blood of my transgression. Jesus, having risen from the grave as he foretold, has granted us eternal life and great mercy.
Bless your people and bless your inheritance with the body of Lord, mercy, compassion, and the Orthodox Christian house of your brother mercy. Through the intercessions of the most related to those of all the servants of Mary, by the power of the precious and life giving cross, protecting God of the Bible, the spouse of heaven, and supplication, the animal glorious prophet, born under John the Baptist, the holy glorious and praiseworthy apostles, all the fathers, all the saints, the great hierarchs, and the biblical teachers, bathing the great rivers, theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, who served on the merciful patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas, Bishop of Mira, C.S. Fair, Bishop Demetrius, and Titus, and the Valleys, John Maxim, Bishop of Shanghai, and San Francisco, Seraphim, and Sarah, from other workers, of the holy glorious great martyrs, born to victorious, the Jews, the merciful, and theater, the victory theaters, the man, the last and martyr worker, the Alamos, like the Eddies, the priest martyrs, the holy glorious great martyr, and all of Lithuania, the holy glorious martyrs, that the barber, Messiah, Catherine, Media, Keith, Bokini, Magdalene, Hapskinia, Rio, Marcella, Theos, the holy glorious and victorious martyrs, the venerable God, the said fathers, the holy righteous ancestors of God, the Kinana, the holy glorious great martyr, Propolios, the holy righteous, they offer us the outpour of herbs. Remember, we commemorate today of all the saints who beseech only merciful Lord, hear us sinners pray to you and have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Thank you.
Sitting on the
calling to, came to you from heaven, O Saint Procopius, and when your mind was enlightened, you abandoned the darkness of idol worship and became for the faithful a shining star, O allotted one. Your august feast of martyrdom illumined all the world with their divine grace, O host and glory of martyr saints.
Grace with resigned to a prayer constantly, let everything every friendly Lord, but the whole world and the nation you're calling to, came through you from heaven, Saint Procopius, and when your mind was enlightened, you abandoned in the darkness of idol worship and became for the faithful a shining star. Oh, allotted one, your august feast of martyrdom illumined all the world with their divine grace. A boast and glory of me, martyr saints.
Christ wondrous and saints, all blessed for Procopius, having boasted through self-control, pride in all the passion and movements of the flesh, you then proceeded courageously, confess of martyrdom, O Spirit of the Lord, has empowered you not to spare even your own flesh, you sustain the
therefore, join them. Glory to God in the highest, glory to you who have shown us the light. Glory to God in the highest, his peace is on earth, his good pleasure in mankind.
Let us begin our divine liturgy at this time. Yeah.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Thank you. So Oh.
Said to the paralytic, rise. rise, take up your bed and go home. And he rose and went home. When the crowd saw it, they were afraid, and they glorified God, who had given such authority to man. Please be seated. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Christ is in our midst. There is a story. Since we are in the time that we are preparing both for the transfiguration of our Lord, and also in the time that we are preparing for the 15 days of August, there is a story. It is not a real story, but it is a story, nonetheless, of edification for us. And the story goes like this. Our Lord saw that it was time for the second coming to happen. It's a story that is told on Mount Athos to remind each other that at any time, the Lord may judge the earth. It's important for us to remember that in these stories, what we see of God is God as a judge. And as he looked upon the earth, he looked at it as a sinful place, a place that was not worthy of destruction, but worthy of starting over. We have to understand. But in this story, his mother looked at him and said, "Wait, please wait. Give them more time to repent." And of course, as the story goes in these days, "I have given them," his response to his mother was, "I have given them 2,000 years to repent." And yet, look at the state of the world today. What good can come for even yet another day? And upon pleading with him, he finally said, "Okay, we'll wait. And we won't start over just yet." It's a sobering thought, brothers and sisters in Christ. It really is. It's a sobering thought for us to understand. It's not that our Lord Jesus has an itchy trigger finger that he can't wait to destroy us. That's not the point of the story. Indeed, that's not even a good image of our Father in heaven. But rather, it is twofold. Number one, that we need to recognize that indeed the second coming will happen. Possibly in our lifetime. And number two, that we must emulate the lives of the saints who have shown us what we must do in order to be ready to receive our Lord when he comes like this again. These are not easy things for us to see. And indeed, when we see this gospel today, especially this gospel today, we see individuals on the earth in the life of Christ, they thought they knew everything. Right? They knew the scriptures. Jesus looks at this man and says, your sins are forgiven. And they're going, oh, this is blasphemy. I know the rules. You can't say your sins are forgiven if you're a man. I know the rules. I understand those rules. The rules within the law of Moses say, you can't do this. And they missed the part where Jesus had the authority of his Father. They missed the signs of what was actually happening in their days, in their times. Are we too missing the signs? Are we too missing what is actually happening surrounding us in our days? Or are we so focused within our own souls, within our own little conveyor belt motions, that we are neglecting the world around us? The world around us is in pain. The world around us is confused. The world around us doesn't understand most of what is happening in these days. They can't see the entire picture. We who are in the church, we who are in Christ, we need to have the motion of outward thinking. Why? Because the world's lost. It is not that we're always outside of the world. Sometimes, God help us, we're in it. We're just as lost. We're just as confused. We're just as blind as to see what's going on. We focus on the rules and we miss the love that's taking place. Jesus confounds those that just focus on the rules and looks at them and says, What's easier? To say your sins are forgiven you, which no man is supposed to be able to say, or to say rise and walk, which, by the way, no man should be able to say. And then he shows them that he has indeed the authority to pronounce sins forgiven. And that man got up and walked. It's not just today that we find ourselves pressing for ways of giving the word of God's love out to the world. And to be honest, it's not so much that God's love is inadequate to be received by other people. It's just that more and more today, we are more confused and have stopped other avenues. There were centuries where certain avenues, including the church, were wonderful recipients of God's love and wonderful benefactors of God's love to the world. And people received it joyfully. But today, we are judged before we speak. And we have to find ways, unfortunately, of accepting persecution, like St. Paul talks about in the scripture. This was 2,000 years ago, and he's saying things like, bless those who persecute you. Bless them? Are you kidding me? Bless those who are making fun of my Lord? Bless those who, when I come to you with love, you're going to come and say, I'm hating you? We have to bless these people? Are we out of our minds? They hate God, or at least they're acting like it. But we must. We must. Because how else are people going to receive the Lord's love if all they get from us when somebody comes at us angrily? How are they going to receive God's love and perceive it if our response to their anger is more anger? Today we celebrate in the church a man named Procopius. He was a great martyr of the 3rd century, 3rd into the 4th century. He was martyred, depending on which version of his life you read, he was martyred at the tail end of the 3rd century or at the beginning of the 4th century. It was under the Emperor Diocletian, who was famous for killing Christians. He was raised by a Christian mother, a Christian father, who died early, and a pagan mother, who indoctrinated him into all these wonderful gods. Remember Paul, right? You have to have a god for everything. But our little picture up there reminds us how the Greeks had a god for everything. You know, did you sneeze? There's a god for that. So he was raised in this. And Jesus wasn't a part of his life. And then at some point, as he was being sent by Diocletian, because his mother raised him to be a part of the stature of society, because his mother raised him that way, at some point he was sent to go kill Christians. He was going to go pronounce that you guys are dead. You're dead. It's coming. If you don't become, if you don't do the pagan worship, you're going to die. And on the way, like Constantine, he had a vision of the cross in the sky, and he said, you can't do this anymore. Procopius. Anyone heard that name before? Procopius? St. Procopius? Everybody has heard the name Procopius before. Every one of you who is married within the Orthodox Church has heard the name Procopius before. And I'll tell you why. Because at the tail end of the service, at the tail end of the service of the marriage, when we are giving the final blessing, where you know the priest has that list of saints, it's a mile long, you know, you've got to remember all of the different saints, remember the couple of saints, you know, all the rest of the things. They mention Saints Constantine and Helen at the end, and they mention the great martyr Procopius. Does anything I've told you so far in the life of Procopius sound like marriage to you? He wasn't even married. And indeed, as you continue into his life and realize that his mother was still a pagan, we keep going into his life. He was eventually arrested, brought into a temple of idols. His mother was pleading for his life, that he would sacrifice to the idols when he went, and he refused. In fact, he prayed for the idols. They all crumbled and fell. Upon seeing that, many people were converted to Christ, including his mother, Theodosia. And they were all beheaded, unfortunately. Again, why marriage? Why does the church seem to not have anything to say about marriage except you have to die? So when we understand this is another one of those images and messages to our culture that's out there, that marriage is indeed a life of sacrifice. That's actually why he's listed among those saints. That's why Saints Constantine and Helen, they weren't married, by the way. Why would they be listed? They weren't married to each other. That was mother and son. That would be very strange. And they are still listed among the saints that we should remember on our wedding. Why? Because they were God crowned. God crowned them king and queen or emperor. And Procopius received the crown of martyrdom at his time. And not only did he receive the crown of martyrdom, but there were 12 female senators in the region, because it was a pagan region, and in the pagan world, a lot of females were lifted up. They came to see him, and they all received martyrdom crowns, showing that our marriage service is about sacrifice. It's about a witness to Christ, not about anything that's self-serving at all. brothers and sisters, today as we celebrate St. Procopius, as we celebrate this type of martyrdom, we are not being asked right now to give up our lives for Christ, to become objects for the world to kill. It's not what we're being asked to do yet. But we are being asked to be the witnesses, in that respect of martyrdom, the witnesses to God's love in this world. We're being asked to carry the crown of martyrdom, whether or not the Lord indeed makes us worthy of giving up our lives for Him. And how do we do it? By doing what St. Paul tells us in the epistle today. By contributing in liberality, to prophesy in proportion to our faith, to serve in serving, to teach in our teaching, to exhort in our exhortation, to give aid with zeal, to do acts of mercy cheerfully, to let our love be genuine. And more importantly, brothers and sisters in Christ, this is something that we have to do very carefully, but we must do it. We must hate not who, but what is evil. We cannot contribute evil to evil. We have to contribute love to evil, good, and God to what is hateful in our world. And we're supposed to outdo each other in honor. That's what our appreciation dinner is today. This is the way that we begin to show our martyrdom and our witness to Christ in these worlds. This is the way that we begin to walk the footsteps of St. Procopius. This is the way that we begin, just to begin, to prepare ourselves for whatever God decides that He wants to remake our lives in this world. Let us prepare ourselves so that we may be ready to honor the Lord and each other as He has commanded us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please rise, and we will continue our divine liturgy. By the way, if you are following along in our divine liturgy, we are going to be on page 93. That's where the hymnal is going to take us for this hymn. And then after, we will go to the bottom of page 36. So we'll go from 93 for the cherubic hymn and then go to page 36 afterwards. Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, again in countless times we fall down before you, and we implore you, O good one who loves mankind, that you have regarded our prayer, may cleanse our souls and bodies from every defilement of flesh and spirit. Grant to us to stand before your holy altar of sacrifice, free of guilt and condemnation. Grant also, O God, to those who pray with us, progress in life, faith, and spiritual understanding, that they may always worship you with awe and love, partake of your holy mysteries without guilt or condemnation, and be deemed worthy of your celestial kingdom. That ever guarded by your might, we may ascribe glory to you, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the age.
Father, I am greater, heavenly earth, and above.
may present the holy offering in peace.
Thank you. verbo spis quana ies ad nami trego in venis en docibus unissimum Theotokos finali partemum Maria.
Heal the sick, physician of our souls and bodies. Through the grace
compassion, and love for mankind of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and forever into the ages of ages. Let us be attentive, the holy gifts, for the holy people of God, Thaya Tisayis, Shataya Shabi.
Bound by passion, cast out by angels, into the Thank you. Thank you.
blessing of the Lord and his mercy come upon you through his divine grace and love always, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to you, O God, glory to you. Christ, our true God, who rose from the dead through the intercessions of his all-purity, immaculate Holy Mother, by the power of the precious and life-giving cross, protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, supplications of the honorable glorious prophet and forerunner John the Baptist, of the holy glorious and praiseworthy apostles, of the holy glorious and triumphant martyrs, of our righteous and God-bearing fathers, of our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose liturgy we celebrate, of the holy righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of the holy great martyr Procopius, of the holy Theophilus, the outpourer of myrrh of the Pangaparaco monastery, of the appearance of the icon of the most holy Theotokos of Kazan, whose memory we commemorate today, and of all the saints. Have mercy on us and save us, and say us, for you, good and merciful God, who loves mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Not only did they endure every single comment with patience,
But they never once blamed anyone before them. Never once did I hear anyone blame their predecessors who handed them this mess. Not one blame of the past. Indeed, those people apologized to the clergy and the laity on multiple occasions for that which they did not do. Brothers and sisters, our leadership going forward is in the right place. We may not be in the right place, but our leadership is. And we are heading the right direction. If there is anyone that is sharing a different story to any parish in the Archdiocese, then they themselves have an axe to grind, and they themselves should at least be checked, because what I saw could have been much worse. What I saw was contrite people who were working as hard as they could to turn things around in New York. We have to be prayerful for these people. We have to be supportive of these people. We have to recognize that for the first time, I can look in a long time. I used to believe this when I was younger. For the first time in a long time, we can look at the Archdiocese and say, that's us. That's us up there. They're trying. They're working for us. Yeah, that's fine. We're still sending our commitment to them. And maybe it's a little more than we want it to be. But at least now, I feel that we can trust those individuals. We passed a budget. Can you believe this? In all of this mess, we passed a 2-year budget, and it had the applause of the assembly. It was amazing. Absolutely amazing. And it took, by the way, not just, you know, the things that were being done. Things were amended to this budget. From the floor, there were things that were amended to this budget. Line items and things that were added, some that were tweaked, some that were taken about. And on top of it, they are going to do as was suggested by the floor. This is why we have to go. This is why me, who am not, you guys know, I'm not the most financially conscious individual in the world. This is why I need all of you. From the floor, it was suggested that maybe the ministries of the Archdiocese should go through a self-study. What a novel idea. Are these ministries actually viable and useful to our parishes? Or are we throwing money into places that it's not being useful? What a great idea. And the dais looked at it and said, that's a great idea. And Bishop Andoni is actually going to spearhead the study. We're getting work done, guys. This is huge. Huge, huge, huge. And if we are blessed enough, in 2 years, we're going to host the next one. I don't know where. Our metropolis in 2 years, God willing, will host the next National Clergy Lady. I wish I had more to tell you about that. And just hopefully, pray, please. I'd love for us to come in droves to that next. Come in droves to the next one. So the people know that not only are we finding this to be important, but this parish of Holy Trinity and all of our small parishes from our region are forces to be reckoned with, and they must be heard. This is a beautiful, beautiful thing that took place. There's a whole lot of stuff in here that we have to be aware of, not the least of which is that we are in our final week of summer camp for us for this summer. Please pray for those that are traveling to camp this summer, those that are traveling home from camp, as there are those that still have not gotten to their homes yet. And we also want to ask for prayers for our sister parish in Weirton that is going to have their festival this week. It's this Thursday to Saturday. They're going to have their festival. If we have not already shown our support in helping to bake and things like this, we must go and support them. It's kind of a little bit of a conflict of interest for me, because on Saturday is also the Serb Fest. I don't know why they changed it. It used to be at the end of the month. Now I have to figure this out, because I'll be at camp from Wednesday going forward throughout the end of the week up at camp again. But I'm a conflict of interest. I come home, I normally go to the Weird Festival. Now I have to make a call and a head order for my land from the Serbian Fest. It's going to be interesting. We also thank all of those who are here today for the Festival Appreciation Dinner. We are going to, as you can tell, our liturgy has ended a little early, but at the same time, we are going to start on time downstairs. So just be patient as we collect ourselves up here. I also want to acknowledge for myself a personal greeting of an individual that is here from my former parish in Brighton, Pennsylvania, Alex Lounses, who is one of my former Goyans, also a joy, and was a counselor and activities coordinator at our summer camp for the first 3 weeks. He is going home and going to be getting himself back to his schedule as he prepares for NC State in the fall. Was this your junior year? Junior year. So if you have an opportunity to greet him, please do so. Otherwise, we will find our way downstairs. I will bless the food when I get down there. Anything else to announce? There's a lot in here. Anything else to announce? Okay, God bless you. Thank you to our chanters today and all of those that participated with us. Please rise and come forward to receive your blessing at this time.